It makes no sense for Master Chai to have left without a word. But even if he had, he would not have done so unobserved. Someone here will have seen something, I'm sure of it. We should split up and inquire as to whether anyone saw him leave, or failing that, if they have any idea where he might have gone. I will meet you at the Glory Gate to compare notes later on. Master Chai? Why yes, I spoke with him recently, though I recall he was in a rather dour mood, concerned about Yomor's neglect of industry, you see. With Lord Valthry's apparently inexhaustible stores of meal and no great need for money, it's little wonder our businesses were all but forgotten under his rule. But I assured Master Chai that the Boutique of Splendors will do all they can to contribute to the revival of trade here in Yomor, which seemed to satisfy him. He took his leave soon after.
Looking for Master Chai, are ya? Is something amiss?
When last I saw him, he seemed ready to collapse from exhaustion. I insisted he rest and catch his breath, and we talked for a while about his concerns over the city's defenses, amongst other things. He made more than a few valid points. Many of our men are still recovering after your confrontation with Lord Valthry, and finding General Regi in a heap in the middle of the plaza shook us all to the core. The man commanded no small amount of loyalty, and some of our longest-serving soldiers seem lost without him. Indeed, a number of them left. And not that we blame you, of course. Without you and yours, we would still be blind to the error of our ways. Anyway, funding permitting, I propose replenishing our ranks with volunteers from the derelicts in Gate Town. We have a duty to protect not only Yomor, you see, but the surrounding regions of Calusia as well. And I, for one, will welcome any man or woman willing to take up arms for that cause. Indeed, I told him as much, and he seemed relieved to hear it. It was on that note that we parted ways. He headed outside, as I recall.
Aye, I recall a man fitting that description. Asked to speak with the poor buggers lately coming from Wright. Said he wanted to know the state of things down the derelicts, and you can be sure we gave him an earful. Like a food, medicine, clothing, there was plenty to tell.
We hunt high and low for whatever we can scavenge, and it's barely enough to fill our bellies. But folk here don't just want to survive, they want to thrive. When he heard that, he started mumbling to himself. Something about finding us work, I think. Fair play to him, though. Not content with having his ear chewed about the derelicts, he asked about the other settlements and all. After that, I cannot really say. Looked like he was headed for Gate Town when I last saw him. Ah, there you are. How did you fare? Have you learned anything which might offer a clue as to Master Chai's whereabouts? No concern the state of business in Yomor. A hastily written note which reads, Boutique of Splendors, willing to work with Master Chai to rebuild businesses. No concern the state of Yomor's defenses. A hastily written note which reads, Yomor's army, willing to hire recruits from the derelicts and Gaytown. No concern the living conditions in Calusia. A hastily written note which reads, Calusian, seeking work, China is offering employment?
Is he?
Interesting. He apparently paid a visit to the Queen Bee as well. They discussed the possibility of granting admission to customers from outside Yomor, an idea to which the proprietor was surprisingly receptive. Sounds like he's got big plans for the place. Yomor, I mean, not the Bee. Perhaps, but the question remains, where did he go after leaving the city? All we know for certain is that Master Chai has shown great concern not only for Yomor, but the surrounding settlements. It seems logical then that having consulted those within the city walls, he would wish to do the same to those without. Delara, if you would go and make inquiries in Wright, I shall do likewise in Siltide. Gaytown I leave to you, Kaishir. Fair enough. Where shall we meet when we're finished?
Well, top rung would seem to me to be the next most likely destination.
Let us reconvene there. With any luck, one of us will have stumbled upon him by then, but if not, we will be well situated to continue our search. No, the name doesn't ring any bells, but there was a rather dapper-looking missile gentleman here not long ago. He wanted to talk about relations between Wright and Yomor, or rather the lack of them. We lost a great many people to their promises of meal and the chance of a lavish life among the free. And Valthry thought to take even more from us, conscripting the few able-bodied men we had left to guard his paradise. I needn't tell you what happened when the senators came. Such things are hard to forgive. Well, Valtry's gone now. We're curious to see what will become of Yomor in his absence. That's what I told your friend Chinuz, was it? And I'm sure the others said the same. Not what he wanted to hear, I suppose, because he left soon after, and that was that. So he paid a visit to both Wright and Gaytown as well, did he? I see. Kaishir and I glean much the same. He seems determined to salvage what goodwill might yet remain among the settlements of Calusia, the only likely place he has left to go being Amity. Come, if we are quick, we may yet catch up with him. Delara! Elfino! Kaishir! What are you doing here? We might ask you the same thing, Master Chai. We've been looking all over for you. Looking for me? Whatever for. Lady Chai has been nigh inconsolable in your absence. She claims you disappear without so much as a word and bade us return you to her side. What blazes are you talking about? I left a letter for her in our chambers. Though I suppose she could have overlooked it, and when she gets an idea into her head, I can only apologize. No harm done, Master Chai, but since we are here, might I ask what compelled you to come all this way? We are told you have been elected mayor, and from what we have gathered from the nearby villages, you have been inquiring about the people's grievances. Is it safe to assume you mean to take office? Now, let's not jump to conclusions. I did seek to learn about the problems faced by the people of Calusia, that much is true, but I am by no means sure I am the man to solve them. Tackling our many challenges will require resources, and until I secured them, it would not be right to assume the role of mayor. I see. And you believe said resources can be found here? Indeed! The people's grievances are many, but in the course of my inquiries, I have already met with several individuals willing to lend their aid in addressing them. However, there remains one individual crucial to my plans, a man whose counsel might yet make a mayor of me. With respect, such foresight is in itself proof of your suitability. The city needs you, Master Chai, and I am certain this man of whom you speak, whoever he may be, will reach the same conclusion. For what little it is worth, we will vouch for you should he require convincing. I don't know what to say. You don't need to say anything. You've got your actions to speak for you. For as long as I can remember, all I ever wanted was to make a Yomor, but that dream's gone now, burst like a bubble, or a boil, more like it. Anyway, outside of repaying Master Alphino, I haven't had a clue what to do with myself. Spent most days in a daze, but you've been running up and down, trying to find a way to fix this mess for everyone. And I reckon you can do it. You got this lot up Mount Gulag, didn't you? How hard could marrying be? You're going to steer Yomor to a better future, I know it. And I want to help, properly help, do something that makes a difference. I don't know what it is yet, but I'll work it out on the way. If you let me come with you, that is. You give me entirely too much credit, the lot of you. But I cannot deny it gives me heart. Come then, let us press on together. Thank you, Master Chai. But we mustn't get ahead of ourselves. Yomor needs more than a man with good intentions, which is why I am here. To find one with the experience needed to see the city thrive. Who is this man exactly, and are you certain he's here in Amity? Redden is his name, and yes, he is, or was. I had scarcely begun to explain myself when he decided his time was better spent elsewhere. He served as chief advisor to Vorthry's father when he was in office. If Ranjit was the mayor's right hand, one might say Renan was the left, and between them, they kept Yomor on the road to prosperity. The city needs more than a mere man of business, which is why I must find him. But even if you do, what makes you think he'll listen? Before giving chase, might it not be wise to speak with those who know him here in Amity? They may be able to shed some light on his reason for rejecting your overtures out of hand. Yes, I suppose that makes sense. Perhaps we should start with Tristel then. As I recall, you made rather a favorable impression on him. I'm certain he would be willing to talk to us. Greetings, friend. And to you too, Master Chai. I presume you are here to ask after Ridden? I couldn't help overhearing your earlier exchange. Yes, well, with Volthry gone, Yomor wants for a leader. Should no one rise to the challenge, the city could very well collapse. I came here seeking Ren's counsel in the hope that we could build a better Yomor together, and that is still my wish. But given how abominable you were mistreated there, I will quite understand if you choose not to help. Worry not, Master Chai. I bear no grudge against you or the people of Yomor, and I will not see you suffer for Valthry's villainy. As you no doubt gathered from your meeting earlier, Rendon can be rather uncompromising. He has his principles, you see, and little patience for anyone he deems less committed to their own. Your desire to right the wrongs of your past of Yomor's past is quite admirable, but I fear the guilt you bear on the city's behalf works against you. I can see it in your eyes, in the way you carry yourself. It goes without saying he sees it as well. You must let those feelings go, Master Chai. Be more assertive, commit to this course, and prove to him Yomor has the resolve to change. The resolve to change. I believe he was heading towards Pit 8 when he left. If you plan to go and speak with him, I suggest you be firm and clear in your intentions. Very well, to Pit 8 we shall go, and I will not take no for an answer, nay, not even a maybe.
Well, well, it's you again. Well, I see you've invited your friends. Need them to fight your battles for you, do you?
I didn't invite them, as it happens. Though they are indeed my friends. Well, not only mine, but every true Yulmorans. They are the ones who awakened us to the truth, to Lord Forthry's villainy. The famous warriors of darkness.
Are they now?
Yes, they are. It would be no exaggeration to call them our saviors. We owe much and more to their kindness, but we cannot depend on that kindness forever. To do so would be a little different from entrusting our affairs to Lord Vorthry. Nay, we must learn to stand on our own two feet. And I would have them present to witness my attempt.
Hear, hear, Master Chai.
Your sentiments are admirable, yet admirable sentiments do not a nation make. In my capacity as advisor, I once strove to build a better Yulmor. Gave honest counsel to my superiors, drafted laws for the benefit of one and all. But in time, my values fell out of favor. There was no need for them in this paradise Vorthry was creating. And so I left my homeland behind. But you, Chai News, you were content to wallow in indolence under Vorthry's auspices. And so I cannot help but ask myself what manner of nation you intend to build.
I can offer no simple answer to that question. This much I will say. It is my hope that Yulmor can become a nation which her citizens might freely choose to build together. A great many people, myself included, flocked to Yulmor seeking sanctuary. the alternative being to live in fear and die in pain. It seemed an easy choice. And sanctuary we found. As much food and drink as we could ever want. Secured at the cost of the surrounding villages. Little wonder the people gathered at our doorstep, begging to work among the bonded. The free were blind to it all, of course. Content to, as you say, wallow in indolence. In ignorance. Were I mayor, I would first take stock of the city's resources and see that they were assigned equitably. Our days of reckless consumption are behind us. The distinction between free and bonded died with Vow 3. The needs of rich and poor alike must be considered if our nation is to survive. To which end, I would take steps to secure channels for supplies, rekindle relations with nearby settlements, who re-establish industry, reach out to neighboring nations, and the list goes on and on. But I am no ruler, nor even a politician. I am an entrepreneur. My expertise lies in planning and profit. I haven't the knowledge or experience to run a nation. Please, Rendon, will you not help me? Together, we could solve the city's problems. Build a Yulmore for the people.
A Yulmore for the people. I rather like the sound of that. But before I offer you my counsel, I would be certain of your ability to perform the duties of office.
You would?
You ask me to help you solve Yulmore's problems, but first I would see you solve one on your own. Accomplish that, and you will prove both to me and the people that you are a man worth following.
Right then. Is there a particular issue you would have me resolve? You seem to have conducted an assessment of the problems Yulmore now faces. I assume you will agree, therefore, that the matter of dwindling food sources is the most pressing. Yes, meal being neither a desirable nor a less sustainable option, I assume alternative foodstuffs are now required to fill the void. And a man who hungers does not like to contribute much to society, save violence, perhaps. So tell me, how do you propose to solve this problem? Give me a satisfactory answer, and I will consider offering you my counsel. A combination of measures would seem to be in order. One to address the immediate issue of supply, and another that of production. Go on. For the present, Yulmore's coffers can be used to purchase food from our neighbors. This would afford us time to address the underlying problem that affects us all, the long-standing neglect of agriculture. The villages that once served the sources of trade for foodstuffs must be repopulated, their means of production restored. This assumes, of course, that we can rekindle relations with our neighbors, guaranteed security and stability in the region, and most importantly, find people willing to leave the city and take up the rebuilding effort.
My, think of that all by yourself, did you?
Well, yes. It began as a rather abstract plan I drafted some time ago, after speaking with the peoples of Yulmore in the nearby settlements.
You've impressed me, Chinese.
I have? Well, that is a relief. Oh, you haven't secured my support just yet. Only my attention. Grand plans will not be enough to persuade the masses. If you would ask them to rebuild, you must provide them the means to do so. A fair point, Rendon, and one to which I have given much thought. I propose the use of Talos Data in the establishment and maintenance of these settlements. Their employment should drastically improve efficiency and ultimately increase production.
Talos? But Daedalus Stoneworks closed their doors years ago. Without a readily supply of the necessary equipment, the people would starve before your plans could be put into effort. Effect.
Well, as the heir to Daedalus Stoneworks, it just so happens that Talos are my field of expertise. And with a little help, I'm quite certain we can acquire what we need in no time at all.
Rendon is quite right. Building Talos from scratch would require time we simply do not have. Which is why I propose to make use of the long-abandoned Talos which wandered the wilds of Calusia. They will need to be deactivated, of course, and if memory serves, the tools required to do so should still be at top rung. Come with me. Aha! The old memory hasn't let me down. This chest contains canisters filled with a dastardly potent insulating powder capable of halting the flow of ether in a Talos. We need only get within throwing distance of one and let it fly. Thus disabling them without damaging them. Ingenious. An old trick of the trade, nothing more. Once disabled, it should be a simple enough matter to get them to march to Yomor. More extensive repairs can wait. Ordinarily, this is where I would ask you to run along and do the deed, but as I have said before, it's high time we learn to stand on our own 2 feet. Thankfully, throwing canisters is something even I should be able to manage. Come off it, Master Chai! Even if the Talos ain't a threat, there's 101 other things out there waiting to make a meal of you! That does may be, Kaishir, but Rin tasked me with solving this problem, and I will not sit idly by while others risk everything to see my harebrained schemes realized. Not this time. Which isn't to say the mere thought of it doesn't fill me with dread. Truth be told, I can't feel my legs. But if I'm to prove I'm a man worth following, I must lead by example.
Well said, Master Chai.
Yes, well, it should go without saying that I have no intention of dying for this. I've always preferred living to see the fruits of my labors. And to make sure I do, I will require your help. It is as Kaishir says, these lands are dangerous if one is not careful. I would ask you to use my spyglass to look out for any beast that could get in the way of my work. I will also need you to alert me when it is safe to subdue the Talos. Understood? Good. Let's be off to the quick way, through the north gate, and see if we can't find a suitable vantage point for you.
I did it? I did it! Let's move on to another teller, shall we?
I do believe I'm getting the hang of this.
You may leave the next one to me, Delara. Aha! That should do it! Now we have all we need to proceed! I can scarcely believe it. It was a reckless, foolish plan, but somehow, it worked. I did it! Master Chai, I believe I owe you an apology. Your plan to replenish Yulmore's food source showed forethought and sound judgment. What's more, it is plain your time as Daedalus Stoneworks has equipped you to lead, as evidenced by the extraordinary company you keep. You, sir, are more than qualified to be the next mayor of Yulmore. I thank you for your vote of confidence, but the fact remains, I am wholly ignorant of the world of politics. Which is why I would ask you to join me and grant Yulmore the benefit of your counsel. I would be honored. When the people behold these Talos, I have no doubt they will lend you their support. It would seem Yulmore's leadership is at last in capable hands, would you not agree?
We should probably be getting back soon, Master Chai. After you've tinkered with the Talos and all that, Lady Chai's worried sick.
Right then, form a line and make for Yulmore!
What's that noise?
Wicked White! Runaway Talos! Call the guard! All of you!
Is that... Darling, you're back.
But of course I'm back. You didn't see...
Dearest, I can't...
Thank you.
I'm sorry, my darling. It's just the sight of you filled me with such joy, I couldn't help myself.
Oh, no, it's all right, dear. I should have just come out and said what it was I was intending instead of entrusting the task to a hastily scribbled letter.
Does that mean you'll do it?
Well, I'm here, aren't I? I mean, not that my absence signified any unwillingness, you understand? Oh, no, naught could be further from the truth. I only left to enlist the aid of the former mayor's senior advisor. And now that I have it, I believe I am ready to take office.
Oh, how wonderful!
That was quite a reception, one Master Chai will struggle to forget. More seriously, the arrival of the Talus has seized the public's attention. Once word is spread around Yomor, it will be that much simpler to gather one and all so that Master Chai can make his inaugural address.
No need to fret, Delara, I've never felt better.
And not at all overawed by the prospect of addressing the assembled masses of Yomor. As for where to do it, if we're to accommodate everyone who might feasibly wish to attend, I suppose the only place large enough would be the Emergent. Then I will go and spread the word among the citizens, both free and bonded, that they are to assemble there to meet their new mayor. You there, Kaishir, was it? Would you go and inform the residents of Gaytown and derelicts? Of course I will. Good lad, I will let the guards know not to bar the way to all three chambers. It goes without saying that I expect the Warrior of Darkness to attend, assuming she is available. Might as well see it through to the bitter end, eh? The doorman at the Crown Lift will show you up. Ah yes, Master Chai told us to expect you. The immersion is already filling up with people of all persuasions. Free and bonded. Citizens and non-citizens. But for you, our guests of honor, we have received a place at the front. Right this way, miss.
Go on, dear.
Thank you all for gathering here today. But before going any further, could I ask the free citizens of Yulmore to look around? Tis a sight none of us would ever have seen under Lord Forthree's rule. Not only do we stand in the familiar presence of those we once called the Bonded, but today we welcome the peoples of the Derelicts and Gate Town too. Today we welcome the Warriors of Darkness, come to bear witness to Yulmore's new beginning. As you know, an election was recently held, at the end of which I had the honor of being chosen to succeed Lord Vorthry. You place great faith in me, and I promise to do my utmost to live up to your expectations, and I will seek always to carry out the duties of this office with integrity and fairness. Always, I say, but not forever. Let it be known that I do not intend to hold this post indefinitely. I consider myself but an acting mayor, who will serve only for the interim, while Yulmore is reshaped according to a new set of values. No longer can we think of ourselves as divided, as the free and the bonded, citizens and non-citizens. The systems put in place by Lord Vorthry must be undone. But even as we tear down the old, we must give thought to the new, to what manner of nation Yulmore should become. Whatever the answer may be, it cannot be decided by one man alone. And so I propose that an open forum be held, that we might all discuss how best to strive towards a better future. However, there can be no talk of the morrow unless we first address the issues of today. Securing new sources of food, rebuilding relations with our neighbors, re-establishing industry. There is much and more that needs to be done. Too much for a mere man of business. And so I pledge instead to do everything in my power to ensure our city's security and stability while we all work together to see these problems solved. The road before us will not be easy, and I know full well how daunting the prospect of honest labor may seem to some of you. But we must accept the reality of our circumstances. We must move forward. This much we owe to ourselves and to the brave heroes who risked their lives to bring back the night. Once we have shored up our city's foundations and regained some semblance of normality, let us reconvene to speak of the future. Until then, I humbly ask that you lend me and each other your strength. For Yulmore!
That was a fine speech, Master Chai. I believe your words stirred every soul in attendance. Stirred them to action, I hope. If I have learned anything from all this, it is that change begins with the individual. 'Tis but a matter of finding the strength to take the first step. Assuming my fellow Yomorians can, it shall be my honor and privilege to help them walk this road we have chosen. But we must not forget the individuals who made all these changes possible.
Were it within my power, I would carve a tribute to your heroism into the very stone upon which the city stands.
I hate to change the subject, darling, but now that you have officially taken office, have you given any thought to your mayoral seat?
We will not be moving into the Emergent, dearest. It's too big for one thing, and too far from the people for another. We will retain our current residence, and I will govern here in the Parlor.
Oh, I was hoping you'd say that. I much prefer the view from the Parlor.
Begging your pardon, Master Chai, but have you got time for a word?
Yes, of course, Hathen Bet.
Ah, that's me. I liked your speech, but there's folk outside these walls that don't even have enough food to last till tomorrow, and more who are counting their crumbs. If you have a plan to change that, I want to help set things in motion.
Then we much to discuss.
No sooner do I take office than my work begins in earnest. Well, I suppose I brought it upon myself. Thank you again for your help, Delara. Hope to see you again before long.
What a day. I don't know what it means exactly, but I do know I've got plenty to think about.
I sense we all have a great deal to consider. I had resolved to remain here until such time as Yomura's future was secured, but it is clear to me now that the city is in capable hands. I have every confidence they will find their way, and I believe it is time we went on ours.
So Alfano's leaving too, is he? Seems like everyone's moving on. Everything's changing. I've been thinking about what I should do in all this. Like I told you, I spent most of my life dreaming about living here with my friends and paradise. That paradise is gone, but something better is taking its place, and I reckon I want to be a part of it. This Yulmore for the people Master Chai's been going on about ain't going to build itself after all. Not that I'm much of a builder. Me and my friends will find a way to make a difference, though. Help keep things changing for the better.
A far nobler dream than the one to which you clung before, and one am I happy to see we share. Whatever path you choose, I will pray for your success.
Well, when you put it like that, there's no going back now, is there? We've got a few ideas on how we can do our bit, just a matter of taking the first step.
Truly, to see Kaishir thus inspired by our actions is inspiring in itself.
Yeah, however much I may wish to stay and see what comes of his efforts here in Yomor, we have matters of our own to attend to. Come, we should return to the Crystal Tower. Mayhap Bayaluk's studies have borne fruit in our absence.
Welcome back. We are given to understand a new mayor has taken office in Yomor.
Indeed, our good friend Master Chai was elected by popular vote, and, after some considerable soul-searching, chose to accept the post. It is a shame you weren't able to attend his inaugural speech, though I have no doubt you will see more of him in the future. But tell me, how fared you in preparing the White Oricite?
Our work did not proceed quite as expected. In your absence, we had a frank discussion on the principles of soul transference, and concluded at length that White Oricite was ill-suited for our purposes.
But Urinage, did you not say that compared to the massive soul of an Ascian, the stone could house one of ours with ease?
That I did, and armed as we are with Begaluk's invaluable insight, would indeed prove a trifling matter, were we to disregard the invaluable link twixt mind and soul. A link which would, we debilitedly realize, be weakened most perilously in the process of rendering our souls dormant, as Erisite doth require. Thus, the shedding of these fleshy semacula and the surfia of ether which comprises them would in all likelihood deprive us of our psyches as well. It would theoretically be possible to channel your minds into the Aura site instead, but we would more than likely sacrifice your souls in the process. Which is why we have abandoned that plan, and instead devoted our time to finding a means by which mind and soul might be transported together.
Then we are no closer to a solution than when we first began.
It is a vexing conundrum indeed, but one for which the Crystal Exarch has posited a most intriguing solution.
When our discussions turn to the transference of memories and the psyche, I cannot help but be reminded of a technique with which I have personal experience. Delara, do you recall what we learned of my eyes from our encounter with Doga and Unai? I speak of the royal eye of the Allegan Imperial line, gifted to my forebears through the blood and memories of the ancient Allegans. It is by this gift that I am able to control the Crystal Tower.
If we were to gain understanding of the technology by which the Allegans were able to accomplish this transference, mayhaps then we could keep mind and soul together.
Imagine, if you will, a device like onto a soul crystal, replete not only with our worldly memories, but also the bountiful energies of the soul. That is our current avenue of investigation, and we will follow it wheresoever it leads.
While we are thus engaged, I think it best that Delara return to the source and inform Kryl and the others of our findings. Agreed. I imagine Tataru will be relieved to hear we've made progress of a sort.
Then I would beg leave to relay our findings on the Thancred and Rhene, and to assist where I may in their investigation of the Empty. Yes, please do. Should we have need of your counsel, we would not hesitate to summon you.
Give our regards to Tataru, won't you? Delara, you're back! How did everything go in the first? Wait, don't tell me. Kryl will be here shortly and she'll want to hear it too. She's just tending to the others. Their bodies, I mean. Guys, I don't think I'll ever get used to saying that. Anyway, you can tell us everything the moment she gets here.
Sorry to keep you waiting. I've carried out the treatment as per Master Matoya's instructions. It should slow the destabilization of their corporeal ether quite significantly. But tell me, how fare our friends in the first? So this Beklug's the first to lead an authority on Soulcraft, are they? Sounds promising. And Uriange's proffered solution of white aurasite is rather ingenious now that I think of it. Well, while they press on with their preparations, you may rest assured we will continue to do our part here.
Oh, you're back. And none the worse for wear, I see.
Estinian! Oh, thank the gods! We've been worried sick. Did you lose your link pearl or something?
The situation in Garlemald has become more complicated. I was making my escape from the capital when I ran into one of yours, Riol. He thought it best we come straight here.
More complicated how?
Where to begin? After entering the Empire via Ra's at Han, I went about my mission of investigating Black Rose. It was then inside a provincial factory, that I encountered the one who styles himself Shadow Hunter, Gaius Baelsar. Our goals being apparently aligned, we joined forces and ventured on into the heart of the capital, to the very Imperial Palace itself. There, we found a man whom all assumed dead. But his soul lives on, and he has wrested back his flesh. Xenos Ye Galvus. Nor did the surprises end there, for no sooner had we arrived than he murdered his sire in cold blood. The Emperor is dead. This sent Gaius into a rage, and he charged in, blade drawn. What's wrong?
I've seen him in action, his body at least. You will not best him alone.
Nay, death will not come easily to that thing. If you would join me, then by all means.
For what good it will do.
A black wolf and the Azuri Dragoon. I suppose this might suffice.
Come then.
Ah, the simple pleasure of one's own flesh. Truly, there is no place like home.
Abomination.
Whatever he is, Delara was barely a match for him. If we stay here much longer.
Imperial Varus, your radiance, are you alright?
Oh. We may wear out our welcome.
Your radiance, no!
Must even the most mildling of sport be spoiled? The world conspires to bore me. But I have no cause to remain. I leave these vermin to you.
Xenos!
Well, any bright ideas?
Just one.
The intruders have taken flight. I repeat, the intruders have taken flight. Deploy all available magic tech armor. We cannot let them escape. Well, well, someone's been busy. And you would bar my way, would you? So be it. Come, Nidhogg, lend me your strength!
garlands and their machina. Now, where are you, Gaius?
Are you all right?
Peer into my past, did you?
Well, I didn't quite relive the experience as you did, but I bore witness to it all.
I'm still not sure what I think of this gift of yours, but no matter. Our confrontation was cut short when the Imperial Guard arrived. It was then that Xenos took his leave, citing boredom.
To think their research into the Echo could bear such fruit. Escaping death, jumping from one body to the next, and returning to his own after all this time. He is an Ascian in all but name.
It beggars belief, aye. But no more than a hero traversing the rift between worlds. My concerns are far more prosaic. With the Emperor dead and the Crown Prince missing, the Empire is in disarray. Until order is restored, assuming it even possible, we needn't fear an Imperial reprisal. And for reasons of his own, Xenos took it upon himself to rid the world of Black Rose. Riol has already gone to apprise the Alliance leaders of these developments. We may leave the matter in their hands for now.
Then perhaps we have seen the last of the fighting at Gimlet. Though, if it comes to civil war, I cannot help but fear for the provinces. Ah, I'd nearly forgotten to ask. What became of Gaius? Did he not escape with you?
That he did, but we parted ways shortly after leaving Garlemald. He claimed another threat had arisen which demanded his attention. He didn't elaborate, but the absence of some device or other in the capital gave him reason to believe they're planning something. Lest you worry, I believe he has well and truly shed the Black Wolf's pelt. Conquest is no longer his objective. We may safely leave him to his own devices.
Well, it's nice to have one less foe to worry about, even if we do have a mysterious new threat to look out for instead. Speaking of which, I'll see that Riol and our shinobi are made aware, though we still know next to nothing. It can't hurt to be vigilant.
Well then, with Black Rose nipped in the bud, I believe I've fulfilled my part of the bargain.
That's true, but with the Archon still slumbering away, we were hoping you might agree to stay with us for a little bit longer.
Sorry, but I'm not inclined to extend my contract. Gaius isn't the only one with business to attend to.
Thank you for your help then, Estinian. I see why Alfno admires you so.
Farewell, my friend. See that you don't make a habit of dozing off in battle.
Thank you. I suppose we should all be getting on then. As ever, we will see to the Archon's needs. In the meantime, why not get some rest? You've more than earned it. Go on.
You must be shattered after all that hopping back and forth between worlds. Why not stay here and rest for a while? I'm sure Bad Luck can manage without you. They've got enough silence to help them if you ask me.
Meanwhile, in Garlemald.
Traitors! You would dare deny Lord Nerva the throne?
Onward! Before this day is done, victory shall be ours!
You think? I find it amusing, like dogs herding cattle to the slaughterhouse.
The hue. Your soul is... Who are you?
Before your majesty, I am but another dog, lost in want of a new master. A hunting dog, if you should wish it so. For I know full well the prey you would seek next.
Zodiark.
Meanwhile, in Yomor in the first.
Did you hear? The mayor's pre-opening date of the stoneworks and they're looking for laborers.
There's talk of reselling some of the old abandoned villages too. They're even laying on free towels to help anyone willing to make the move.
Free towels? Huh, we best get packing.
Steady work, board and lodging? If that's not a recipe for hope, I don't know what is.
Hope?
Yes, so long as I yet live, I would see that feeble flame rekindled.
It is my destiny to see our dream fulfilled.